I used to lose track of where I was mid-workout. Did I already do that set? Did I finish this exercise for the day? So in this part two video in my series on building a fitness tracker in Notion, I'll show you all the buttons that I created to make setting up a workout and then tracking each exercise effortless. It's simple logic based on very easy formulas that make a huge difference in keeping this system clean and efficient. I'm Anthony Wagner, and this is QueerEfficiency, where I help productivity nerds solve tiny problems. Okay, remember in the last video that we're trying to set up a fitness tracker that looks just like this, and we got to the point where we had added the exercise column, the ability to track what weight we're on, to track what set we're on, and also a demo image. We also set up our today view with a filter so that we only see the items that have a set enabled. Now we want to make this actually useful. We want to add some buttons to create functionality for this tracker, specifically with the goal in mind of using this on mobile. So the first thing that I want to do is let's enable this reset workout button. Let's actually add its functionality. The goal here is if the set column is what we use to turn exercises on for today. The goal of the reset button is to blank those out. It's very simple. So we're going to come here, we're going to choose new action, then we're going to choose edit pages in. We're going to select the database that we're in. And again, this is where it's helpful to have the word database on there so it's easy to spot among your other things. We're going to select the database, and Notion is pretty good at showing near the top of the list the databases that are on your current page. So we're going to pick this one. Then we're going to choose edit property, set, and all we have to do is leave it empty. That's it. So when I hit done, we can hit reset workout, and there they go. Now, if for some reason in the future you wanted to add a last edited time property, which is a property that allows you to see when the record was last edited, and there's a variety of use cases for that if you just want to see which ones you worked on last, I have a bit of a better solution for that coming up later in this video, but let's just say you wanted to. We want to make this a little future-proof. The better thing to do is to filter the pages where set is not empty. You could also tell it to do where set is greater than or equal to zero, be the same thing, but where set is not empty. So it's only gonna act on those pages and not the others. So let's just test this. I'm gonna add a number here. Again, to quickly duplicate this down, all I have to do is select that cell, choose shift on my keyboard, hit the down arrow, and then hit control or command D, and it will copy the same thing down. Let's test this again, and all of those should go away, which is perfect. So that button, it's all set. The next thing we want to do is we want to be able to quickly turn on and off an exercise so it shows up as an exercise we want to do today. It's kind of clunky to have to enter a cell and then enter a number manually, especially if you're doing it on mobile. That's kind of a pain in the ass. So the way we're going to fix that is add a button. We're going to come here, scroll down, and choose button. And we'll name this today. And we'll give that a day icon. And then we need to edit the automation that's involved. So when the button is clicked, do this action. And the very simple version would be edit a property, edit the set, and just insert a zero, right? And when we hit save, then we can choose this and those turn on and they show up in the today view, no problem. I will say, while we're on the today view, probably don't need the today button, so we could hide that from here. But on the main view, the setup view, we do need it. And I would actually move this over to the left. So again, on mobile, we can drag this a little more narrow. On mobile, this is easy to get to. So that's almost finished. Actually, it could be finished. You could stop right here. But I would add one more refinement, because let's say you're at the gym and you toggled this on and you decide, I don't want to do chest flies today. You'd have to come to this cell and delete it or reset the whole workout to get it to go away out of your today view. The better thing to do would be to modify the formula just slightly so that it could handle taking care of the turning on and turning off functionality. So let's come back here and edit. And then instead of zero, we're gonna edit this as a formula instead. We'll delete that from here. And what we wanna do very simply is if the set is set to zero, blank the value, otherwise set it to zero. So that's really simple to put in a formula. We're gonna say if, and then an if statement takes three parameters. The first is the condition, is the actual thing we're checking. And then the second is what happens if that's true. And the third is what happens if that's false. There's a few different ways you could set this up. You could say if this page, so the page, again, this is a button and it's gonna be operating on a single page. So if this page dot and you add a dot, which allows you to then get to the other properties, and we want to say set is equal to zero, and in programming languages, a lot of times the single equal like this sets a value. So like if you were saying x equals zero, you're assigning a value to x versus this, which is checking to see if set equals zero. So if set equals zero, then, and I'm going to do this incorrectly right at first, you'll see in a second, but basically we want to insert a blank just for illustrative purposes. I'm just going to insert a plain blank for a sec. Otherwise, we want to insert a zero, right? We want to make it blank if it's already equal to zero, and then otherwise we want to make it zero. Now, Notion is going to yell at me and it's going to say, you can't have a return type of unknown. This must be a number. We're operating on the set property, which is a number property, so it has to have a number. Let's just to confirm the functionality, let's set this instead of blank, let's set it to one. So now what should happen is if it's zero, when you hit the button, it'll change to one. And if it's one, it'll change back to zero. So let's just test that and see how it works. So what should happen is when I hit this today button, this should toggle on and then it should toggle back and forth between one and zero. And that's exactly what's happening. Now we don't want it to be one, right? We want it to be empty. So there's a funky workaround to fix this. It's very simple, but I kind of wish that it didn't have to be this way. I wish Notion was smart enough to know that a blank is fine. Typically, if you're using a text property to blank something, you just insert an empty double quote, right? So if I wanted to insert a name instead, and I could put my name there, that would insert that name if it was a text property. Again, we're working with a number, so that's not gonna work. So what we want is this blank, but we have to make it a number. And so Notion has a function for making something a number, which is very simply toNumber. And we need to put the quotes and hit save. And that's it. Now what should happen is it'll toggle between zero and off, which is great because we can toggle these on. And let's say we wanted an incline row and a floor T-raise. Oh, I don't actually want that. Turn it right back off. Very simple. The next thing we want to be able to do is when we're doing our exercises to be able to quickly add a set. So that way we can keep track of what set we're on. So we can come to the today view. We don't have to, we could do it on the other view. That's fine too. So let's add a button and call this plus set. And I'll give this a plus icon. Okay. And then we'll move this closer to the left so that we can see it on mobile. And what we have to do is simply increment the set column by one. That's all, it's very straightforward. So we'll come here, we'll choose edit. And then we're gonna edit a property. And again, we wanna edit set. And we're gonna use a custom formula again. And we're gonna say this page dot set plus one. So it's gonna take the existing value and increment it by one. If we just entered one there, it would constantly write one, which is not useful. So we'll hit save and save. And now, let's move this over. We can count and it'll keep going forever, right? As many times as we click it. But obviously we really only need it up to three. Let's actually turn one of these back on. Now let's add a couple little quality of life improvements to this. What I've learned over time in using my fitness tracker is that it's really handy to know when I last did the exercise. So that way as I'm rotating between groups, let's come back here. And let's say today I did upper body and I typically rotate between upper and lower body. So I would do upper body, like arms one day. This is simpler. Mine is a little more broken down, but I just wanted a simpler example. But in my real one, I would do arms one day, core another. So I went from upper body, and then the next day I went to core to give my arms a rest. And then I'll go from core to chest and shoulders, and then I'll go to legs, just as an example. I find that sometimes by that third day, I forgot what I did 2 days ago. So it's very handy to be able to see which exercises did I do most recently. The nice thing is we're already tracking our sets, and so wouldn't it be handy if we were able to, every time we did a set, to track when that set happened? Okay, very easy, let's do that. So we wanna add a new property, and we're gonna add date, a date property, and we'll call it last set. I can leave that calendar icon, that one's just fine. And then what we wanna do is every time we complete a set and hit this button, we wanna populate this with the current date and even the current time it could be. So I'm gonna edit this automation and we're going to keep all this the same. We're just gonna edit another property, last set, and choose time triggered and save. Now what happens, make that a little wider, is when we hit this plus button, it will track the date. And then even fancier, what we could do is add a new view. We'll add a table. We can move this over You can probably hide the rest of these. We'll call this view history. And then we'll add an icon. We'll search past, and that gives me this handy icon. We'll call that history. And then we'll sort this descending. So the most recent ones appear at the top. So let's just come back here and add some sets. Make this simpler so I don't have to go back and forth. We can turn that on and then just add some sets. And then you can see here, obviously it will sort when you're not doing every single one back to back to back. The times will be a little different. And so you'll be able to see them in order. And this is very handy so that when you sit at your weight bench or wherever you are, you can look at your history and see, oh, I recently did upper body and back. Maybe today I need to do core or I need to do lower body. The last improvement I want to make to this today is to make it a little easier to see which sets you're on. So right now, as we add sets, they all stay here. And this little ring indicator is handy, but we can make it a little bit better. So let's blank these out. Let's turn a few exercises on. And then we're going to come here and we're going to add a group. And we're going to group by set. And then we want a number, not by 100, but by 1. Should be all we have to modify. And now what happens, you see it says 0 to 1 right here. When I hit set, it's gonna jump down and that one's done. So I know that for my first set, I can rotate between these and complete them. And then let's just do another one. Let's say we did another bench press. We can see that the groups are gonna change. And you can see it adds a group. Now let's make sure that hide empty groups is on, which it is. So that way, when we reset this, and add some exercises again, that grouping just resets itself, which is great. Now you could also do, let's say you wanted to do chest flies back to back to back. You could do 1, 2, 3 and be done, and then do 1, 2, 3 and be done. And it's very easy to see. All right, the last thing we're gonna add is something that's really cool. It is a little more complex, but it's really cool and incredibly handy to have. We're gonna add this log where it tracks the date and the weight that the exercise was. Now this has a little error, which I actually corrected for in the formula. This takes a little bit more of a formulaic approach, so we're gonna do that in the next video to condense it. Don't worry, it's not super crazy and I'll walk you through it step by step, but it's a really cool feature to have so that in my demo, when I increase the weight, so let's say this went from 20 to 25, what will happen is after a second, it will populate here, but let's say this one went from 27.5 to 30. Give it a second, and it does the same thing. And in this view, it is condensed, but when you click into it, you can see it very easily. And then also, you can see it right here, also very easily. So you can track your progress over time and how far between increasing the weight you were. So we'll do that in the next video. If you found anything in this video helpful, I would love it if you could scroll down and give it a like. It tells the algorithm to show my videos a little bit more, and it also tells me what type of content you like that I'm creating and to make more stuff just like that. Thanks, as always, for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.